Now, we'll try and understand Islam in the right perspective by trying to understand the concept of God in Islam. The best reply that any Muslim can give you regarding the concept of God in Islam is quoted to you Surah Ikhlas, chapter number 112, verse number 1-4, which says, Kul huwa Allahu ahad. Say, He is Allah one and only. Allah has samad. Allah, the absolute and eternal. Lam yalid walam yulad. He begets not, nor is he begotten. Walam yakul lahu kufuwan ahad. There is nothing like him. This is a four-line definition of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, of Almighty God, given in the glorious Quran. Any person says so-and-so candidate is God, if that candidate fits in this four-line definition, we Muslims have got no objection in accepting that candidate as God. The first test is, Kul huwallahu ahad. Say, He is Allah one and only. Allah has samad. Allah, the absolute and eternal. Lam yalid walam yulad. He begets not, nor is he begotten. Walam yakul lahu kufuwan ahad. There's nothing like him. This is a four-line definition of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala given in the glorious Quran, which we call it as the litmus test for theology. Theo means God. Logy means study. Theology means the study of God. Surah Ikhlas is the litmus test of theology. It is the touchstone of theology. I hope you understand when I say the word touchstone. Touchstone means if you go to buy some gold jewelry, you want to know how pure is the gold. So you go to a goldsmith and he takes that gold jewelry and rubs it against a touchstone. And then he compares it with the color chart he has got. And then he says whether the gold is 24 karat gold or 22 karat. 18 carat, or you may say it is not gold at all, because all that glitters is not gold. Surah Ikhlas is the touchstone of theology. Any candidate you say is Almighty God, put him to the test of Surah Ikhlas. If that candidate passes the test, we Muslims have got no objection in accepting that candidate as God. For example, there are some human beings who believe that Bhagwan Rajneesh is God. Once during question answer time, a Hindu brother of ours, he told me, Brother Zakir, we Hindus don't believe him to be God. I told him, I never said that the Hindus believe him to be God. I've studied the Hindu scriptures. Nowhere do the Hindu scriptures say he's God. What I said, some people, some human beings believe him to be God. Let's put this God to the test of Surah Ikhlas. The first is, Kul huwa Allahu ahad. Say, He is Allah one and only. Was Rajneesh one and only? Was he the only man who claimed divinity, who claimed to be God? There are hundreds of men who have claimed to be God, especially in this country of ours, India. There are thousands who have claimed to be God. He's not the only one. But a Rajneesh Bhakt, a Rajneesh follower will say, no, he's unique. He's the only one. Let's go to the next test. Next is Allahu Samad. Allah, the absolute and eternal. Was Rajneesh absolute and eternal? When we read his autobiography, he writes in his autobiography, he was suffering from chronic backache, from asthma, from diabetes mellitus. Imagine, Almighty God suffering from chronic backache, from diabetes mellitus, from asthma. The third is, Lam yalid walam yulad. He begets not, nor is begotten. And we know that Rajneesh, he was born in Madhya Pradesh. He had a mother and father. And later on, in May 1981, he goes to America. And in the state of Oregon, he starts his new village called as Rajneeshpuram. And he takes thousands of Americans for a ride. Later on, the American government arrests him and put him behind bars. He alleges, the American government gave me slow poisoning. Imagine Almighty God being slow poisoned. And in 1985, the American government kicks him out of the country. He comes back to India in the state of Maharashtra. He goes back to the city of Pune, to his center, which was called as Neo Sannyas. Today, it's called as Osho Commune. And if you visit Pune, And if you go to a center, which is called an Osho commune, if you go to a samadhi, it is mentioned there on the stone on a samadhi, Bhagavan Rajneesh, Osho, never born, never died, but visited the earth from the 11th of December 1931 to the 19th of January 1990. Never born, never died, but visited the earth from the 11th of December 1931 to the 19th of January 1990. They forgot to mention on a samadhi that he was not given visas to 21 different countries of the world. Imagine Almighty God coming in this world to visit different countries, and he requires visa to go to different countries. And the Archbishop of Greece said, if you don't remove Rajneesh out of this country, we'll burn his house and the house of his disciples. And the last test, the fourth test, walam yakullahu kufuwan ahad, there's nothing like him, is so stringent that no one besides the true Almighty God can pass. The moment you can compare God to anything in this world, he is not God. Walam yakullahu kufuwan ahad. We know very well that Rajneesh, like a common human being, he had two eyes, one nose, one mouth, white beard, two hands. The moment you can compare God to anything in this world, he is not God. Walam yakullahu kufuwan ahad. For example, if someone says, Almighty God is 1,000 times stronger than Arnold Schwarzenegger. You might have heard the name of Arnold Schwarzenegger, the person who was given the title Mr. World, the strongest man in the world, Mr. Universe, the strongest man in the universe. The moment you can compare God to anything in this world, whether it be Arnold Schwarzenegger, whether it be Dara Singh, or whether it be King Kong, whether it be 1,000 times or 1,000,000 times, the moment you can compare God to anything in this world, he is not God. Walam yakullahu kufuwan ahad. There's nothing like him. This is a four-line definition of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala given in the glorious Quran. Any candidate says, any person says that this candidate is God, if that candidate fits in this four-line definition, we Muslims have got no objection in accepting that candidate as God. So I request all my brothers and sisters, whichever religion you may belong to, put your God to the test of Surah Ikhlas. If he fits in this four-line definition, he is a true Almighty God, otherwise he's not.